دعوتك ربي ومن لي سواك فيا ربي حقق دعاء من دعاك دعوتك والقلب في فرحة يناجيك يا خالقي في علاك وأنت البصير وأنت العليم بحالي ونور الحجام ضياك رأيتك ربي في كل شيء فزاد اليقين بقلب رآك ففي الزرع في الضرع في الأنس بانت بدائع صنعك بعض نداك.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارزقنا علما نافعا يا سميع الدعاء يا رب العالمين. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. As usual, every Thursday we go through the halaqa of the sublime beauty of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is from the book of Ash-Shama'il Al-Muhammadiyyah by Imam Muhammad ibn Isa At-Tirmidhi rahimahullahu ta'ala, who died in year 279 after Hijrah. Rahimahullah, rahmatan wasi'a. In his book Shama'il Al-Muhammadiyyah, he brings the chapter Babu Maja'a fi Tuka'ati Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What has been narrated concerning the reclining of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. حدثنا عباس بن محمد الدوري البغدادي قال حدثنا إسحاق بن منصور عن إسرائيل عن سماك بن حرب عن جابر بن سمرة قال رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم متكئا على وسادة على يساره. عباس بن محمد الدوري البغدادي narrated to us. إسحاق بن منصور narrated to us from إسماعيل from سماك بن حرب that جابر بن سمرة رضي الله تعالى عنه said I saw رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم reclining on a cushion on his left side. Actually, this hadith is recorded by Abu Dawood and Imam At-Tirmidhi rahimahumullah in their Sunan. Next one is حدثنا حميد بن مسعدة قال حدثنا بشر بن المفضل قال حدثنا الجريري عن عبد الرحمن ابن أبي بكرة عن أبيه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ألا أحدثكم بأكبر الكبائر قالوا بلى يا رسول الله قال الإشراك بالله وعقوق الوالدين قال وجلس رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وكان متكئا قال وشهادة الزور أو قول الزور قال فما زال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقولها حتى قلنا ليته سكت. Humayd ibn Musa'adah narrated to us. Bishr ibn al-Mufaddal narrated to us. Al-Jariri or Al-Jurayri narrated to us from Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Bakrah that his father Abu Bakrah radiallahu ta'ala anhu said Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, should I tell you about the greatest of the major sins, al-kabair, min akbar al-kabair? They said, certainly ya Rasulullah. He said, associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ishraku billah, and defiance against parents, meaning uququl walidain. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sat up as he was reclining and added and false testimony, which is shahadat al-zur, or false speech, which is qawla zur. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kept saying it so much that we said, if only he would keep silent. If only he would keep silent. This hadith is recorded by Imam al-Bukhari rahmatullahi alayhi as well as his student Imam Muslim al-Hajjaj rahmatullahi alayhi recorded it. Next hadith, حدثنا قتيبة بن سعيد قال حدثنا شريك عن علي بن الأقمر عن أبي جحيفة قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أما أنا فلا آكل متكئا. Qutaybah ibn Sa'id narrated to us, Shariq narrated to us from Ali ibn al-Aqmar that Abu Juhayfa radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, as for me, I do not eat while reclining on the left side. Next, this hadith is recorded by Imam al-Bukhari in his Sahih, Imam Abu Dawood in his Sunan, Imam al-Tirmidhi also in his Sunan as well. So next hadith, حدثنا محمد بن بشار قال حدثنا عبد الرحمن بن مهدي قال حدثنا سفيان عن علي بن الأقمر قال سمعت أبا جحيفة رضي الله تعالى عنه يقول قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا آكل متكئا. محمد بن بشار narrated to us, عبد الرحمن بن مهدي narrated to us, سفيان narrated to us that علي بن الأقمر said I heard Abu Juhayfa radiallahu ta'ala anhu saying, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I do not eat while reclining. This hadith is recorded by Imam al-Bukhari, by Abu Dawood, and by Imam At-Tirmidhi rahimahumullah ta'ala. Next hadith, حدثنا يوسف ابن عيسى قال حدثنا وكيع قال حدثنا إسرائيل عن سماك بن حرب عن جابر بن سمرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم متكئا على وسادة قال أبو عيسى لم يذكر وكيع على يساره وهكذا روى غير واحد عن إسرائيل نحو رواية وكيع ولا نعلم أحد روى فيه على يساره إلا ما رواه Ishaq ibn Mansur an man? An Israel. Yusuf ibn Isa narrated to us, Waqi' narrated to us, Israel narrated to us from Simak ibn Harb that Jabir ibn Samurah radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, I saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam reclining on a cushion. This particular hadith is riwayah is recorded by Imam Abu Dawood and Imam At-Tirmidhi rahimahumullah. Abu Isa said, Waqi' did not mention ala yasari, which means on his left side. Similarly, others have reported similar to the narration of Waqi', this particular narration, such as the report of Israel, and we do not know any of the riwayah, any of the narration that mentions on his left side, except illa what has been reported by Ishaq ibn Mansur from Israel, rahimahumullah. Next chapter of Servants of Allah is Maja'a fi ittika'i Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. What has been narrated concerning the leaning of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam? Haddathana Abdullah ibn Abdul Rahman, qala haddathana Amr ibn Asim, qala haddathana Hamad ibn Salama, an Humayd, an Anas, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, anna Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wasallam kana shakiyan fakharaja yatawakka'u ala Usamah ibn Zayd wa alayhi thawbun qitriyun qad tawashaha bihi fasalla bihim. Abdullah ibn Abdul Rahman narrated to us, Amr ibn Asim narrated to us, Hamad ibn Salama narrated to us from Humayd that Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was feeling ill, so he came out leaning on Usama ibn Zayd radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, wearing a garment of Yemeni sheet made of cotton, qitri, which he had thrown on loosely. He then led them in the salah. In the prayer. This is recorded by Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala in his Musnad. And Imam Hibban rahimahullah ta'ala also recorded this. Next hadith, and that is the last hadith on the ittika of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is that haddathana Abdullah ibn Abdul Rahman qala haddathana Muhammad ibn al-Mubarak qala haddathana Ata ibn Muslim al-Khaffaf al-Halabi qala haddathana Ja'far ibn Burqan an Ata ibn Abi Rabah عن الفضل ابن عباس قال دخلت رسول الله على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في مرضه الذي توفي فيه وعلى رأسه عصابة صفراء فسلمت عليه فقال يا فضل قلت لبيك يا رسول الله قال أشدد بهذه العصابة رأسي قال ففعلت ثم قعد فوضع كفه على منكبي ثم قام فدخل في المسجد وفي الحديث قصة. This tradition is part of lengthier story. So Abdullah ibn Abdul Rahman narrated to us, Muhammad ibn al-Mubarak narrated to us, Ata ibn Muslim al-Khaffaf al-Halabi from Syria narrated to us, Ja'far ibn Burqan narrated to us from Ata ibn Abi Rabah. By the way, he was black. Ata ibn Abi Rabah rahimahullah ta'ala, he was mufti of Mecca, so much so that he also had physical disability rahimahullah rahmatu wasi'ah. That he narrated from Fadl ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, brother of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, that I visited Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam during his sickness, during his illness in which he passed away. On his head was a yellow band. I greeted him and he said, O Fadl, I said, at your service, Ya Rasulullah, Labbayka Ya Rasulullah. He said, fasten firmly this band on my head. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to Fadl ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma. So I did. He then sat up and placed the palm of his hand on my shoulder. Then he stood up and entered the masjid, which is the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This is recorded by At-Tabarani in Mu'jam al-Kabir, volume 18, page 280. Having said that, there is weakness in this hadith. This riwayah is da'if. Next chapter, fi sifati akli Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And this is actually important for us when it comes to the mannerism regarding eating the food. What has been narrated concerning the manner of eating of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam? حدثنا محمد بن بشار قال حدثنا عبد الرحمن بن مهدي عن سفيان عن سعد بن إبراهيم عن ابن لكعب بن مالك عن أبيه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يلعق أصابعه ثلاثة. قال أبو عيسى وروى غير محمد بن بشار هذا الحديث قال يلعق أصابعه الثلاث. Okay. Muhammad ibn Bashar narrated to us, Abdurrahman ibn Mahdi narrated to us, from Sufyan, from Sa'ad ibn Ibrahim, ibn al-Ka'ab, ibn Malik, that his father, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, said the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to lick his fingers clean three times after eating. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to lick his fingers clean three times after eating. This hadith is recorded by Imam Muslim ibn Hajjaj rahimahullah ta'ala in his Sahih, and Imam Abu Dawud also recorded this hadith in his Sunan. Abu Isa said, this riwayah has been narrated by other than Muhammad ibn Bashar. He said he used to lick his three fingers. So here in this one we have fingers, Rasulullah licked his fingers clean three times, didn't mention three, but another narration is that he used to lick his three fingers. Next hadith, حدثنا الحسن ابن علي الخلال قال حدثنا عفان قال حدثنا حماد ابن سلمة عن ثابت عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله تعالى عنه قال كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا أكل طعاما لعق أصابعه الثلاث. Al-Hasan ibn Ali al-Khallal narrated to us, Affan narrated to us, Hamad ibn Salama narrated to us from Thabit that Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam ate a meal, he used to lick his three fingers clean after eating. This hadith is recorded by Imam Muslim ibn Hajjaj as well as Imam Abu Dawud rahimahum Allah ta'ala. Next hadith, حدثنا الحسين ابن علي ابن يزيد الصدائي البغدادي قال حدثنا يعقوب بن إسحاق يعني الحضرمي, meaning from Yemen. قال حدثنا شعبة عن سفيان الثوري عن علي بن الأقمر عن أبي جحيفة رضي الله عنه قال قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أما أنا فلا أكل متكئا. This is another route. But going back to Abu Juhayfa radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the same hadith that I read earlier, that amma ana fala akulu muttaki'a, meaning that as for me, I do not eat while reclining. So this riwayah from different chain is recorded by Imam al-Bukhari, Imam Abu Dawud, and Imam At-Tirmidhi rahimahumullah. Next hadith is حدثنا محمد بن بشار قال حدثنا عبد الرحمن بن مهدي قال حدثنا سفيان عن علي بن الأقمر نحوة. Similar hadith was narrated from Muhammad ibn Bashar Muhammad ibn Bashar narrated to us, Abdurrahman ibn al-Mahdi, ibn Mahdi narrated to us, Sufyan narrated to us from Ali ibn al-Aqmar, who narrated the same tradition, same riwayah with different chain of narration. So one hadith pretty much more than two chains. Next hadith, حدثنا هارون ibn Ishaq al-Hamdani قال حدثنا عبدة بن سليمان عن هشام بن عروة عن ابن لكعب بن مالك عن أبيه قال كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يأكل بأصابعه الثلاث ويلعقهن. هارون بن إسحاق الهمداني narrated to us, عبدة بن سليمان narrated to us from هشام بن عروة ابن الكعب ابن مالك that his father رضي الله تعالى عنه said Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would eat with his three fingers and would clean them after eating. This particular riwayah is recorded by Imam Muslim and Imam Abu Dawud rahimahumallah. Last hadith on the chapter of Sifatu Akli Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is حدثنا أحمد ابن منيع قال حدثنا الفضل ابن دكين قال حدثنا مصعب ابن سليم قال سمعت أنس بن مالك يقول أُتِيَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمَ بِتَمْرٍ فَرَأَيْتُهُ يَأْكُلُ وَهُوَ مُقْعِمٍ مِّنَ الْجُوعِ. Ahmad ibn Mani' narrated to us, Al-Fadl ibn Dukayn narrated to us that Mus'ab ibn Sulaiman said, I heard Anas bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu saying, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was gifted some dates, tamr. I saw him eat them while he was hunched over due to hunger. Ju'a. This is also recorded by Imam Muslim, Ibn Hajjaj and Imam Abu Dawood, rahimahum Allah. Sifatu Khubzi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the chapter about description of the bread of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. حدثنا محمد بن المثنى ومحمد بن بشار قال حدثنا محمد بن جعفر قال حدثنا شعبة عن أبي إسحاق قال سمعت عبد الرحمن بن يزيد يحدث عن الأسود بن يزيد عن عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها أنها قالت ما شبع آل محمد من خبز الشعير يومين متتابعين حتى قبض رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سبحان الله. Muhammad ibn al-Muthanna and Muhammad ibn Bashar narrated to me. Muhammad ibn Ja'far narrated to us. Shu'ba narrated to us that Abu Ishaq said, I heard Abdurrahman ibn Yazid narrated from Al-Aswad ibn Yazid that Aisha, Ummul Mu'minin Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, said, the family of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never satiated on barley bread, khubz al-sha'ir, for two consecutive days until Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was taken from this world. This is recorded by Imam Muslim ibn Hajjaj, Imam At-Tirmidhi and Imam Ibn Majah rahimahumullah alayhi majma'in. Next hadith. حدثنا عباس ابن محمد الدوري محمد الدوري قال حدثنا يحيى ابن أبي بكير قال حدثنا حريز بن عثمان عن سليم ابن عامر قال سمعت أبا أمامة الباهلية رضي الله تعالى عنه يقول ما كان يفضل عن أهل بيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خبز الشعير. عباس بن محمد الدوري narrated to us. يحيى بن أبي بكير narrated to us. حريز بن عثمان narrated to us that سليم بن عامر said, I heard أبو أمامة الباهلي رضي الله تعالى عنه saying, there was never sufficient barley bread for the people of the household of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, meaning Ahlul Bayt. Okay, meaning Ahlul Bayt. This particular hadith is recorded by Imam At-Tirmidhi rahimahullah ta'ala. Next hadith, Haddathana Abdullah ibn Muawiyah al-Jumahi. قال حدثنا ثابت بن زيد عن هلال بن خباب عن عكرمة عن ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما قال كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يبيت الليالي المتتابعة طاويا هو وأهله لا يجدون عشاء وكان أكثر خبزهم خبز الشعير. عبد الله بن معاوية الجمحي narrated to us. ثابت بن يزيد narrated to us from هلال بن خباب from Ikrimah that Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family would spend consecutive nights starving, not finding any supper, and most of their bread was barley bread. This is recorded by Imam At-Tirmidhi rahimahullah ta'ala. This hadith is supported by other riwayah and other narration, which will come later in this book, inshallah. Next hadith, حدثنا عبد الله بن عبد الرحمن قال حدثنا عبيد الله ابن عبد المجيد الحنفي حدثنا عبد الرحمن بن عبد الله بن دينار قال حدثنا أبو حازم عن سهل بن سعد أنه قيل له أكل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم النقي يعني الحوارة فقال سهل ما رأى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم النقي حتى لقي الله عز وجل فقيل له هل كانت لكم مناخل على عهد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ما كانت لنا مناخل قيل كيف كنتم تصنعون بالشعير قال كنا ننفخه فيطير منه ما طار ثم نعجنه. Abdullah ibn عبد الرحمن narrated to us. Ubaydullah ibn عبد المجيد الحنفي narrated to us. Abdurrahman ibn Abdullah ibn Dinar narrated to us. Abu Hazim narrated to us from Sahal ibn Sa'ad radiallahu ta'ala anhu that he was asked, did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam eat the finest flour? meaning white bread, Sahal said, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam never saw the finest flower tip until a flower up until he met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he was asked, did you have sieves in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam? He said, we did not have sieves. He was then asked, how did you prepare barley? He said, we used to blow on it, so whatever husks on it would fly off, and then we would knead it into dough. Into dough. This particular hadith is recorded by Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah ta'ala, along with Imam at-Tirmidhi, rahimahullah ta'ala. Next one, حدثنا محمد بن بشار قال حدثنا معاذ بن هشام قال حدثني أبي عن يونس عن قتادة عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله تعالى عنه قال ما أكل نبي الله صلى الله عليه وسلم على خوان ولا في سكر رجة ولا خبز له مرقق. Muhammad ibn Bashar narrated to us, Mu'adh ibn Hisham narrated to us, my father narrated to me from Qatada that Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, did not eat food on a table nor in a bowl, and nor did he have refined bread. Yunus rahimahullahu ta'ala said, I asked Qatada, then what did they eat on? He said, on these leather mats, sufur. Okay, the sufra that we call in Arabic, sufur. This is recorded by Imam al-Bukhari and Imam at-Tirmidhi rahimahumullah. Muhammad ibn Bashar said, this Yunus who narrated from Qatada is Yunus al-Iskaf. Okay, Yunus al-Iskaf. حدثنا next hadith حدثنا أحمد بن منيع قال حدثنا عباد بن عباد المهلبي عن مجالد عن الشعبي عن مسروق قال دخلت على عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها فدعت لي بطعام وقالت ما أشبع من طعام فأشاء أن أبكي إلا بكيت قال قلت لما قالت أذكر الحالة التي فارق عليها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم والله ما شبع من خبز ولحم مرتين في اليوم. Ahmad ibn Mani' narrated to us, Abbad ibn Abbad al-Muhallabi narrated to us from Mujalid, from Ash-Shabi, that Masruq said, I went to see Ummul Mu'minin Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. So she ordered food for me and said, I never have my fill of food and then want to cry, except I start crying. I said, why? She said, I remember the state in which the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam departed from this world. By Allah, he never had his fill of bread and meat twice in one day. Allahu Akbar, Subhanallah. Imam at-Tirmidhi recorded this hadith. However, this hadith is da'if. Having said that, min bab at-targhib, if we were to look into it, it goes to show that even people can be happy and satisfied and be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with something that is little. Okay, meaning that food was not wasted. Next hadith is حَدَّثَنَا مَحْمُودِ بِنْ غَيْلَانِ قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا أَبُو دَوُودِ قَالَ حدثنا شعبة عن أبي إسحاق قال سمعت عبد الرحمن ابن يزيد يحدث عن الأسود ابن يزيد عن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت ما شبع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من خبز الشعير يومين متتابعين حتى قبض. Again, this hadith was read earlier. So this hadith is recorded by Imam al-Bukhari, Imam Muslim, and Imam at-Tirmidhi rahimahumullah. It is through different chain of Mahmud ibn Ghaylan. Next hadith, rather the last hadith on the chapter of Sifatu Akli Rasulullah, Sifatu Khubzi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Haddathana Abdullah ibn Abdul Rahman. Qala haddathana Abdullah ibn Amr. Abu Ma'mar. Haddathana Abdul Warith. An Sa'id ibn Abi Aruba. An Qatada. An Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Qal, ma akala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala khiwanin, wala akala khubzan muraqqaqan hatta mat. Even this hadith was recorded earlier in the chapter earlier. Even this hadith is recorded by Imam al-Bukhari, Imam Muslim, rahimahumullah. Now, Babu ma ja'a fi sifati idami Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Idam means curry or the sauce, right? That is what it is. Another English word can be used for this was is condiments. So it is idam, the sauce that comes with the meat or vegetable or anything that was being cooked back in the day. So حدثنا محمد بن سهل عن ابن سهل بن عسكر وعبد الله بن عبد الرحمن قال حدثنا يحيى بن حسان قال حدثنا سليمان بن بلال عن هشام بن عروة عن أبيه عن عائشة رضي الله عنها أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال نعم الإدام الخل نعم الإدام الخل قال عبد الله بن عبد الرحمن في حديثه نعم الإدام أي الأدم الخل okay أي أو الأدم الخل محمد Ibn Sahal al-Askar and Abdullah ibn Abdul Rahman narrated to us. Yahya ibn Hassan narrated to us. Sulaiman ibn Bilal narrated to us. From Hisham ibn Urwa, from his father, that Ummul Mu'minin Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what an excellent idam or curry, excellent idam vinegar is. Okay. Khal in Arabic, that is the Arabic word for vinegar. This hadith is recorded by Imam Muslim ibn Hajjaj and Imam Muhammad ibn Isa at-Tirmidhi rahimahullah. Abdullah ibn Abdul Rahman in his riwayah said, how excellent is the condiment or the idam or the vinegar is. Vinegar is. Next hadith is Haddathana Qutaybah. قال حدثنا أبو الأحوص عن سماك بن حرب قال سمعت النعمان بن بشير رضي الله تعالى عنه يقول رضي الله تعالى عنهما يقول ألستم في طعام وشراب ما شئتم لقد رأيت نبيكم صلى الله عليه وسلم وما يجد من الدقل ما يملأ بطنه قتيبة narrated to us أبو الأحوص narrated to us that سماك بن حرب said I heard نعمان بن بشير رضي الله تعالى عنه said saying, do not indulge in whatever food and drink. Do you not indulge in whatever food and drink you wish? Meaning, do you not go beyond the board? I saw that your Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was unable to find poor quality dates with which to fill to his stomach. Allahul Musta'an. Daqal. Okay. Ad-daqal. Poor quality dates. The dates that you would see people wouldn't buy. This is recorded by Imam Muslim ibn Hajjaj and Imam Muhammad ibn Isa at-Tirmidhi rahimahumullah. Next hadith of servants of Allah is Haddathana Abdat ibn Abdullah al-Khuza'i Qala Haddathana Muawiyat ibn Hisham An Sufyan An Muharib ibn Dithar An Jabir ibn Abdullah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Ni'mal idamul khal It is different chain now. But it is the first hadith that we read on this chapter, Ni'ma al-idamul khal, which means what an excellent condiment vinegar is. Okay, this is recorded by Imam Muslim, Imam Abu Dawood, and Imam At-Tirmidhi, rahimahumullahu rahmatan wasi'ah. Next hadith is حدثنا هناد قال حدثنا وكيع عن سفيان عن أيوب عن أبي قلابة عن زهدم الجرمي قال كنا عند أبي موسى الأشعري فأتي بلحم دجاج فتنحى رجل من القوم فقال ما لك فقال إني رأيتها تأكل شيئا فحلفت ألا آكلها قال ادنو فإني رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يأكل لحم دجاج Hannad narrated to us, Waqi' narrated to us from Sufyan, from Ayyub, from Abu Qilaba, that Zahdam al-Jarmi radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, we were in the presence of Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu ta'ala anhu when he was served chicken. Upon seeing the dish, one of the men in the group withdrew. One of the men in the group withdrew. So he asked him, what is the matter with you? He replied, I saw it eat something. So I swore that I would not eat it. Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, come close because I have seen Rasulullah ﷺ eating the meat of the chickens. This hadith is recorded by Imam al-Bukhari and his student Imam Muslim al-Hajjaj radiallahu ta'ala rahimahumullahu alayhim ajma'in. Next hadith of servants of Allah is from Al-Fadl ibn Sahal. He narrated, Al-Fadl ibn Sahal al-A'raj al-Baghdadi narrated, قال حدثنا إبراهيم ibn Abdul Rahman ibn Mahdi meaning he said that Ibrahim ibn Abdurrahman ibn Mahdi narrated to us an Ibrahim ibn Umar ibn Safina, from Ibrahim ibn Umar ibn Safina, who narrated from his father, who narrated from his grandfather, an abiha an jaddihi qal akaltu ma'a rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lahma hubara. Al-Fadl ibn Sahal, he said that his grandfather said that I ate meat with bastard, meaning hubara, together with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This is recorded by Imam At-Tirmidhi and Imam Abu Dawud, though this hadith is weak. Okay, the hadith is da'if. Next hadith, O servants of Allah, brothers and sisters. Haddathana Ali ibn Hujr, qala haddathana Ismail ibn Ibrahim. عن أيوب عن القاسم التميمي عن القاسم التميمي عن زهدم الجرمي قال كنا عند أبي موسى الأشعري رضي الله تعالى عنه قال فقدم طعامه وقدم في طعامه لحم دجاج وفي القوم رجل من بني تيم الله أحمر كأنه مولى قال فلم يدنو فقال له أبو موسى أدنو فإني قد رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أكل منه فقال إني رأيته يأكل شيئا فقذرته فحلفت ألا أطعمه أبدا. Pretty much same meaning as the hadith before. However, it is from different chain. Ali ibn Hujr narrated to us, Ismail ibn Ibrahim narrated to us from Ayyub, from Al-Qasim al-Tamimi, that Zahdam al-Jarmi radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, we were in the presence of Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu ta'ala anhu when we were served food that had chicken meat in it. Among those present was a man from tribe called Banu Taymullah. Okay. Ruddy as if he were a freed slave, Mawla. And he did not come close to the food. So Abu Musa radiallahu ta'ala said, come closer because I've seen Rasulullah eat it. The man said, I saw it eating something unclean. So I swore that I would never eat it. This hadith, there is no da'af in it. The hadith is not da'if, rather it is recorded by Imam Bukhari, Imam Muslim, and Imam Muhammad ibn Isa at-Tirmidhi rahimahullah. So it is about, you know, someone who is not preferring, but it is actually eating chicken is not haram because we do eat, alhamdulillah. Next hadith is Haddathana Mahmud ibn Ghailan qala haddathana Abu Ahmad al-Zubayri wa Abu Nu'aym qala haddathana Sufyan an Abdullah ibn Isa an rajulin min ahli al-Sham yuqalu lahu Ata' عن أبي أسيد قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كل الزيت والدهنوا به فإنه من شجرة مباركة. محمود بن غيلان narrated to us, Abu Ahmad al-Zubayri and Abu Nu'aym narrated to us, Sufyan narrated to us from Abdullah ibn Isa that a man from the people of Syria, meaning Sham, named Ata ibn Abi Asid, Asid رضي الله تعالى عنه said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, eat olive oil. So az-zayt that we know, even in this particular statement of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, if we were to say az-zayt, in traditional Arabic we know az-zayt means oil. But here in this hadith, az-zayt means olive oil. And it was not mentioned that zayt is zaytun specifically. So az-zayt, the actual meaning is olive oil. And apply it, because indeed it is from the blessed tree, shajaratim mubarakah. Okay, this is recorded by Imam At-Tirmidhi. This hadith is accepted due to supporting narration such as the following hadith, and the following hadith we'll go through now. حدثنا يحيى بن موسى قال حدثنا عبد الرزاق قال حدثنا معمر عن زيد بن أسلم عن أبيه عن عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كل الزيت والدهن به فإنه من شجرة مباركة. قال أبو عيسى وعبد الرزاق كان يضطرب في هذا الحديث فربما أسنده وربما أرسله. Yahya ibn Musa narrated to us, Abdul Razak narrated to us, Ma'man narrated to us from Zayd ibn Aslam, from his father Aslam, that Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, eat olive oil and apply it, because indeed it is from a blessed tree. Abu Isa said, Abdul Razak was confused in his ascribing of this tradition. He may have provided a complete chain of transmission and may not have. Before the statement of Abu Isa, The hadith that was mentioned, it was recorded by Imam Muhammad ibn Isa At-Tirmidhi in his Sunan, and Imam Ibn Hibban, rahimahullah ta'ala, also recorded this hadith. Next hadith, حَدَّثَنَا السِّنْجِي وَهُوَ أَبُو دَوُودْ سُلَيْمَانْ ابْنْ مَعْمَدَ السِّنْجِي قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا عَبْدُ الرَّزَاقِ عَنْ مَعْمَرْ عَنْ زَيْدِ بْنِ أَسْلَمْ عَنْ أَبِيهِ عَنِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ نَحْوَهُ وَلَمْ يَذْكُرْ فِيهِ عَنْ عُمَرْ. Okay, similar hadith narrated, but it is narrated by Aslam from Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَلَمْ يَذْكُرْ فِيهِ عُمَرْ, meaning it was not mentioned that عَنْ عُمَرْ ibn al-Khattab رضي الله تعالى عنهما. This particular hadith is recorded by Abd al-Razzaq in his Musannaf. Okay, next hadith, حدثنا محمد بن بشار قال حدثنا محمد بن جعفر وعبد الرحمن بن مهدي قال حدثنا شعبة عن قتادة عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله تعالى عنه قال كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يعجبه الدباء فأتي بطعام أو دعي له فجعلت أتتبعه فأضعه بين يديه لما أعلم أنه يحبه. So Muhammad ibn Bashar narrated to us, Muhammad ibn Ja'far and Abdul Razzaq ibn Mahdi narrated to us, Shu'bah narrated to us from Qatada that Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loved gourd, which is dubba. And upon one occasion, food was presented to him or he was invited by someone to partake of it. So I thought to seek out the pieces in the dish and present them to him, as I knew of his love for it. Subhanallah. This is recorded by Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala in his Musnad, hadith number 12911. Next hadith is, حَدَّثَنَا قُتَيْبَةُ بْنُ سَعِيدٍ قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا حَفْصُ ابْنُ غِيَاثٍ عن إسماعيل بن أبي خالد عن حكيم بن جابر عن أبيه قال دخلت على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فرأيت عنده دباء يقطع فقلت ما هذا قال نكثر به طعامنا قال أبو عيسى وجابر هذا هو جابر بن طارق ويقال ابن أبي طارق وهو رجل من أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا نعرف له إلا هذا الحديث الواحد وأبو خالد اسمه سعد. This particular hadith is, by the way, recorded by Ibn Majah rahimahullah ta'ala. Qutaybah ibn Sa'id narrated to us, Hafs ibn Ghiyath narrated to us from Ismail ibn Abi Khalid from Hakim ibn Jabir that his father Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, I came to visit the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and saw that he had gourd sliced into pieces. So I asked, what is this? He replied, we increase our food with it. Abu Isa said, this Jabir is Jabir ibn Tariq, and it is also said that he is Jabir ibn Abi Tariq. He is a man among the Sahaba radiallahu anhu majma'in of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we know of no other riwayah attributes to him apart from this one. Abu Khalid, his name is Sa'ad. حدثنا قتيبة ابن سعيد عن مالك ابن أنس عن إسحاق ابن عبد الله ابن أبي طلحة أنه سمع أنس ابن مالك رضي الله تعالى عنه يقول إن خياطا دعا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لطعام صنعه قال أنس فذهبت مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى ذلك الطعام فقرب إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خبزا من شعير ومرقا فيه دباء وقديد قال أنس فرأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتتبع الدباء حوالي القصعة فلم أزل أحب الدباء من يومئذ. سبحان الله. This hadith is recorded by Imam al-Bukhari, Imam Muslim and Imam al-Tirmidhi. Qutaybah ibn Sa'id narrated to us from Malik ibn Anas radiallahu ta'ala rahimahullah from Ishaq ibn Abdullah ibn Abi Talha that he heard Anas bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu saying, a tailor once invited Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for a meal he had prepared. So I also attended the invitation with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to that meal. He presented Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam with some barley bread, khubz al-sha'ir, and broth containing dried meat and gourd, meaning the pumpkin. Then I saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam seek out the gourd, meaning the pumpkin, around the sides of the bowl. Thereafter, I never stopped loving gourd. Okay, the pumpkin was loved by other Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in. Next hadith, حدثنا أحمد إبراهيم أحمد ابن إبراهيم الدورقي وسلمة بن شبيب ومحمود بن غيلان قالوا حدثنا أبو أسامة عن هشام بن عروة عن أبيه meaning عروة بن زبير عن أبيه عن هشام بن عروة عن أبيه عن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يحب الحلوى والعسل حلواء والعسل أحمد بن إبراهيم الدورقي سلمة ابن Shabib and Mahmud ibn Ghailan narrated to us, Abu Umama narrated to us from Hisham ibn Urwa, from his father, that Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to love sweets, halwa, and honey, asal. It is recorded by Imam At-Tirmidhi rahimahullahu ta'ala. Next hadith, Haddathan al-Hasan ibn Muhammad al-Za'farani. Now, this particular rawi is from Iran, current Iran. قال حدثنا الحجاج بن محمد قال ابن جريج أخبرني محمد بن يوسف أن عطاء ابن يسار أخبره أن أم سلمة أخبرته أنها قربت إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم جنبا مشوية فأكل منه ثم قام إلى الصلاة وما توضأ. Now here comes the issue of طهارة. Al-Hasan ibn Muhammad al-Za'farani narrated to us, Al-Hajjaj ibn Muhammad narrated to us that Ibn Jurayj said, Muhammad ibn Yusuf informed me that Ata ibn Yasar informed him that Ummu Salamah radiallahu ta'ala anha informed him that she served a grilled flank to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, grilled meat to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he ate it. He then stood up to pray without performing wudu, without performing the ritual ablution. This is recorded by Imam At-Tirmidhi rahimahullahu ta'ala. حدثنا قتيبة قال حدثنا ابن لهيعة عن سليمان بن زياد عن عبد الله بن الحارث قال أكلنا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم شواء في المسجد. قتيبة narrated to us, ابن لهيعة narrated to us from سليمان ابن زياد that عبد الله بن حارث رضي الله تعالى عنه said we ate grilled meat with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم in the masjid, meaning masjid رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is recorded by Ibn Majah. In the chain is Abu Ibn Lahi'ah, who is trustworthy. Rajulun thiqah, but became confused after his books were burnt. The books that he kept, or the recording of a hadith, later on he became confused. This is from the Ahlul Hadith, those who are from the Ahlul Hadith background, those who search the hadith from the Jarh and Ta'dil aspect. Next hadith is Haddathana Mahmud ibn Ghailan. He said, Mahmud ibn Ghailan said, narrated to us, he said, Haddathana Waqi' narrated to us, Waqi' said, Haddathana Mis'ar, an Abi Sakhra, Jami' ibn Shaddad. He said that Mis'ar narrated to us from Abu Sakhra, Jami' ibn Shaddad. He narrated from Al-Mughira ibn Abdullah. He narrated from Al-Mughira ibn Shu'bah. رضي الله تعالى عنه. He said, ضفت مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات ليلة فأوتي بجنب مشوي ثم أخذ الشفرة فجعل يحز فحز لي بها منه قال فجاء بلال يؤذنه بالصلاة فألقى الشفرة فقال ما له تربت يداه قال وكان شاربه قد وفى فقال له أقصه لك على سواك أو قصه على سواك. I was a guest with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam one night when a grilled flank was brought to him. He then took a knife and began to carve it into pieces. Then, and he carved some of it for me. Bilal arrived, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, calling him to salah. So he dropped the knife and said, what is wrong with him? May his hands be struck to the ground. His mustache hung down close to his mouth. So he said to him, shall I trim it for you over a tooth stick, meaning with the miswak, with the siwak, or he said, trim it over a tooth stick. Okay, this is the ruling that we found over here. This hadith is recorded by Abu Dawud rahmatullahi alayhi in his Sunan. حدثنا واصل ابن عبد الأعلى قال حدثنا محمد بن فضيل عن أبي حيان التميمي. Wasil ibn Abdul A'la narrated to us. He said, Muhammad ibn Fudail narrated to us from Abu Hayyan At-Taymi, from Abi Zur'a, from Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who said, Uthiya Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bilahmin, farufi'a ilayhi dhira'a, wa kanat tu'jibuhu fanahasa minha. Some meat was brought to the Prophet ﷺ. So the foreleg was given to him and he liked it. So he took a bite of it and ate it. This is recorded by Imam al-Bukhari, his student Imam Muslim, Ibn Hajjaj and Imam At-Tirmidhi rahimahumullah. Next hadith, Haddathana Muhammad ibn Bashar. Muhammad ibn Bashar narrated to us. He said, Haddathana Abu Dawud. Abu Dawud narrated to us an Zuhair, from Zuhair, Ya'ni ibn Muhammad. Zuhair ibn Muhammad, who narrated from Abu Ishaq, an Abi Ishaq, who narrated from Sa'ad ibn Ayyad, who narrated from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who said, Kana Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yu'jibuhu al-dhira'a. Qala, wasumma fi al-dhira'a, wa kana yara anna al-Yahuda sammuh. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to like the meat of the foreleg. He also added, he was poisoned with a foreleg. Okay? As he used to believe that Jews has poisoned him. This particular hadith is recorded by Abu Dawud. This hadith has other supporting narrations which make it hasan, which make it good chain. Next hadith, Muhammad ibn Bashar narrated to us, قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا. He said that Haddathana Muslim ibn Ibrahim, narrated to us. He said, Haddathana Aban ibn Yazid, narrated to us from Qatada, from Shahr ibn Hawshab, from Abu Ubaid. He said, Tabakhtu lil Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qidra, wa qad kana yu'jibuhu dhira', fanawaltuhu dhira', thumma qala nawilni dhira', fanawaltuhu, thumma qala nawilni dhira', faqultu ya Rasulullah, wa kam lishati min dhira', faqal, walladhi nafsi biyadih, law sakatta lanawaltani dhira' ma da'awtuhu. I cooked a pot of meat for the Prophet ﷺ, and he used to enjoy the foreleg. So I passed him the foreleg. Then he said, pass me a foreleg. So I passed it to him. Then he said, pass me the foreleg. So I passed it to him. Then he said, pass me the foreleg. So I said, Ya Rasulullah, how many forelegs does the sheep have? He said, by the one in whose hand is my soul, had you remained silent, you would have kept passing me foreleg as long as I asked for it. This hadith is recorded by Imam Ahmad in his Musnad, volume 3, pages 484 and 485. This hadith has a weak chain. Although Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah ta'ala has mentioned other supporting evidence and declared it authentic in Mukhtasar Shama'il. Okay. In page 96. If you want to go, by all means, you're excused.
Yeah.
Yes.
Zakallah.
Wayyak. Next hadith is Haddathana Al-Hasan ibn Muhammad al-Za'farani. Al-Hasan ibn Muhammad al-Za'farani narrated to us, who said, Yahya ibn Abbad narrated to us from Fulayh ibn Sulaiman, who said, Haddathani Rajulun min Bani Abbad. He said that a man from Bani Abbad narrated to us. He used to be said as Abdul Wahab ibn Yahya ibn Abbad, who narrated from Abdullah ibn Zubayr. Ibn Awam radiallahu ta'ala anhuma from Umul Mumin Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, ما كانت الذراع أحب اللحم إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ولكنه كان لا يجد لحم إلا غبا وكان يعجل إليها لأنها أعجلها نضجا. She said, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, the foreleg was not the meat dearest to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, but he only got to consume meat occasionally. So he would take to the foreleg because it was the quickest portion of meat to prepare. It was really quick to cook. This is recorded by Imam At-Tirmidhi. However, this hadith is weak, da'if. Next hadith, Mahmud ibn Ghaylan narrated to us. He said, Abu Ahmad narrated to us. He said, Mis'ad narrated to us, who said, Sami'tu shaykham min fahm, that a shaykh from Fahm said, that Sami'tu Abdullah ibn Ja'far, he said that Abdullah ibn Ja'far, I heard from him, who said, Sami'tu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul, he said that I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, Inna atiyab al-lahmi lahmu al-dhahr, that the best meat is the meat of the back, lahmu al-dhahr. However, this particular hadith, even though it is recorded by Ibn Majah, it is da'if. Next hadith is Haddathana Sufyan ibn Waqi'. Sufyan ibn Waqi' narrated to us, he said, Zayd ibn al-Habbab narrated to us from Abdullah ibn al-Mu'ammal, from Ibn Abi Mulaika, from Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, and the Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam aqal, ni'mal idamul khal. This hadith has been through, we have been through as well, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what an excellent condiment vinegar is. Okay, this is recorded by Imam Muslim and Imam At-Tirmidhi, rahimahumullah. Next one is Abu Kurayb Muhammad ibn al-Ala narrated to us. He said, Abu Bakr ibn al-Ayyash narrated to us from Thabit ibn Thabit Abi Hamza al-Thumali from al-Sha'bi from Umhani. She said, دخل علي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال أعندك شيء فقلت لا إلا خبز يابس وخل فقال هاتي ما أقفر بيت من أدم فيه خل فيه خل. So Umm al-Mu'mineen, Umhani radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to visit me and said, do you have anything to eat? I said, no, other than some dry bread and vinegar. So he said, bring it, because no household in which there is vinegar is devoid of seasoning. This is recorded by Imam At-Tirmidhi, rahimahullah. This hadith is authentic with supporting evidence. This hadith is sahih. Next hadith. Muhammad ibn al-Musanna narrated to us, he said, Muhammad ibn Ja'far narrated to us, who said, Shu'bah narrated to us from Amr ibn Murrah, from Murrah al-Hamdani, from Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, from al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who said, Fadlu Aisha ta'ala nisa'ika ka fadli thariida ala sa'ir al-ta'am. The superiority of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha over all other women is like the superiority of thareed over all other food. What is thareed? Thareed is bread shredded in broth. You have a soup, broth soup, where you have the bread shredded. That is called thareed. Usually containing meat. Sometimes you would see the meat is also in there with the bread. And this particular hadith is recorded by Imam al-Bukhari, Imam Muslim, and Imam al-Tirmidhi. Okay, at that time, this thareed used to be one of the best, you know, food. The way that, you know, Rasulullah ﷺ compared Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Next hadith. Ali ibn Hujr narrated to us, he said, Ismail ibn Ja'far narrated to us, he said, Abdullah ibn Abdurrahman ibn Ma'mar al-Ansari Abu Tuwala narrated to us, who heard from Anas bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Fadlu Aishata ala nisa'i kafadli thariidi ala sa'ir al-ta'am. Similar hadith, it is recorded by Imam al-Bukhari, Imam Muslim, and Imam al-Tirmidhi, but through different chain, Ali ibn Hujr. Next hadith is Qutaybah ibn Sa'id narrated to us, he said, Abdul Aziz ibn Muhammad narrated to us from Suhail ibn Abi Salih, who narrated from Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, annahu ra'a Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tawadda'a min akli thawr aqit, who saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam making wudu after eating some pieces of cheese, okay, thawri aqit, thumma ra'ahu akala min katifi shat. Then he saw him eating from flank of a sheep. ثم صلى ولم يتوضى. Then he prayed, but he did not make wudu. Okay, without performing wudu. This is recorded by Imam Ahmad rahimahullah in his Musnad. Next hadith, Ibn Abi Umar narrated to us, he said, Sufyan ibn Uyayna narrated to us from Wa'il ibn Abi Dawood, from his son, who is Bakr ibn Wa'il, who narrated from Az-Zuhri, who narrated from Anas bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, أولم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم على صفية بتمر وسويق. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم gave a wedding banquet for his marriage with who? With Safiya radiallahu ta'ala anha, with dates, tamar, and a drink made from barley, sawiq. Okay, this was just a wedding banquet, you could say walima, awlama. Okay. And this was the walima only. Rasulullah dead. And when we are doing walima, we're wasting too much. Wallahu al-musta'an. Next hadith. Al-Husayn ibn Muhammad al-Basri narrated to us, he said, Al-Fudayl ibn Sulaiman narrated to us, who said, Fa'id Mawla, freed slave, Fa'id, freed slave of Ubaidullah ibn Ali ibn Abi Rafi', who is freed slave of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who said, Haddathani Ubaidullah ibn Ali, that Ubaidullah ibn Ali narrated to us, An jaddatihi, from his grandfather, grandmother, An jaddatihi, from his grandmother, Salma, that Al-Hasan ibn Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, wa ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, wa ibn Ja'far, and son of Ja'far radiallahu ta'ala anhum, atawha faqalu laha, isna'i lana ta'aman mimma kana yu'jibu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa yuhsanu akla. Faqalat ya bunay, la tashtahihi al-yawm. Qala bala isna'ihi lana. Qala faqamat fa'akhadat shay'an min sha'ir fatahantuh thumma ja'altuhu fi qidrin wa sabbat alayhi shay'an min zaytin wa daqqat al-fulfula wa tawabila faqarrabathu ilayhim. Faqalat hatha mimma kana yu'jibu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa yuhsanu akla. Prepare for us a meal which Rasulullah used to like and enjoy eating. She said, oh my dear sons, you will not enjoy such food today. They said, surely we will, prepare it for us. She stood up, took some barley and ground it, then placed it in a pot and poured olive oil over it, crushed the pepper and the spices and presented it to them, and said, this is what Rasulullah used to like and enjoy eating. This is recorded by Imam At-Tabarani in his Mu'jam Al-Kabir, in his book called Al-Kabir, volume 24, page 299. Having said that, this chain of narration is da'if. This isnad is da'if. Next hadith. Mahmud ibn Ghaylan narrated to us, who said, Abu Ahmad narrated to us, he said, Sufyan narrated to us from Al-Aswad ibn Qais, from Nubayh al-Anazi, from Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, Atana al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to our house, fi manzilina, fadhabahna lahu shat, so we slaughtered a sheep for him. Faqal, ka'annahum alimu anna nuhibbu al-laham. He said, it is as if they knew that we love meat. Wa fil hadith qissa. This hadith is part of a longer incident. Okay, longer story. This is recorded by Imam Ahmad in his Musnad. Ibn Abi Umar narrated to us, he said, Sufyan narrated to us, he said, Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Aqil narrated to us, who heard Jabir saying that Sufyan wahaddathana Muhammad ibn al-Munkadir, and Muhammad ibn al-Munkadir narrated to us from Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who said, kharaja Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ana ma'a. Rasulullah sallam went out and I'm with him. Fadakhala ala imra'atin min al-ansar. And he went to a house of a woman from al-ansar, from Medina. Fadhabahat lahu shatan. So she slaughtered a sheep for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fa'akala minha. Rasulullah sallam ate from that sheep. Wa atathu biqina'in min rutabin. And he then... She then served him a dish of fresh dates, rutab, fresh dates. ثم توضأ للظهر. Then he made wudu for Salat al-Dhuhr. وصلى صلى الله عليه وسلم. Rasulullah sallam prayed. ثم انصرف. Then he left. فأتته بعلالة من علالة الشاة. Then she came. After praying, he returned and she served him with the remaining meat from the sheep, and he ate it. فأكل. ثم صلى العصر. Then he prayed Salat al-Asr, and he did not perform wudu. Without performing wudu. This hadith is recorded by Abu Dawood and by Imam At-Tirmidhi, rahimahumullah. Next hadith, O servants of Allah, brothers and sisters. Al-Abbas ibn Muhammad Ad-Duri narrated to us. He said, Yunus ibn Muhammad narrated to us. He said, Fulayh ibn Sulaiman narrated to us. From who? From Uthman ibn Abdurrahman, who narrated from Ya'qub ibn Abi Ya'qub, who narrated from Ummul Munzir radiallahu ta'ala anha. She said, Dakhala alayya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ma'ahu Ali. Rasulullah sallam came to me and with him was Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Walana dawalin mu'allaqa. We had some dates hanging. Qalat, she said, Faja'ala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ya'kulu wa aliyun ma'ahu ya'kul. Faqala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam li'aliyin, mahya Ali, fa innaka naqihun. قالت فجلس علي والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يأكل قالت فجعلت له لهم سلقا وشعيرا فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لعلي من هذا فأصب فإن هذا أوفق لك. When Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu began to eat with him, Rasulullah said to him, stop, Ya Ali, as you have just recovered from a sickness. You just have recovered from an illness. Okay. Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu then sat down while Prophet continued to eat. I then prepared for them some shards, meaning silk, shards and barley, meaning sha'ir. Okay. The Prophet said to Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, eat from this because indeed it is more suitable for you as you have just recovered from the sickness. This is recorded by Imam At-Tirmidhi rahimahullahu ta'ala. And he said, this riwayah is hasanun gharib, good gharib. We only know this tradition from Fulayh rahimahullahu ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all our efforts. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us thabat and give us tawfiq to act upon the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma ameen. Hada ma indi wal ilmu inda Allahi alayhi tawakkaltu wa ilayhi unib.